In this video, we're going to demonstrate how to measure valve springs. The first measurement to take is valve spring installed height, and this is done with the valve spring installed in the cylinder head before it's removed. And this can be done with a digital caliper. When you do this, this is a measurement that only includes the valve spring, and so you want to measure from the surface that the valve spring sits on the cylinder head to the top of the valve spring, not including the retainer. And you want to take that measurement on the caliper. And in some cylinder heads, it's kind of tight. There's not a lot of space, and so you can use a small mechanics ruler or something else to make that measurement. So again, you just go from the top of the valve spring to the bottom of the valve spring, and don't include anything else when you make that measurement. Once you've got the valve spring installed height measured, we want to measure the free height, and that can be done again with a caliper. We're also over here at this tool, so we set the valve spring inside of there. We bring the arm down until it just touches the top, and we take the measurement there to see how high the free height is. That's important because valve springs come in different heights, and sometimes you get a valve spring that fits but is the wrong height, and therefore it has the wrong pressure on the valve. Now while we're here, this will also allow us to measure the valve spring pressure. And to do this, we measure at the valve installed height. And so we bring it down to the height that's specified out in the specifications. We can lock this stopper. So we push it all the way down to where it should be. We take this stopper. I think we've gone a little bit too far back up. Say it specifies to be right there. We'll lock this stopper. And now we can get all of our valve springs in quickly, put them in there, pull it down, and check to see what our pressure is. In this case, the pressure is about 51 psi, and that's, or 51 pounds, I should say. And we compare that to specification. And then there is a valve open height. That's also in your specification, so you find out how far we should compress that valve spring when the valve is opened. When we get it there, we set the stopper. We come down and compare that reading. In this case, we're at 105 pounds. We compare that to specification. And we can quickly, with that stopper set, we can quickly check all of our valve springs. And then lastly, while it's here, this is a great time to check the valve spring to make sure that it's not bent. Now, valve springs, you've noticed that none of these measurements are very precise on valve springs. This isn't precise either. We just kind of want to rotate the valve spring and make sure that it's pretty consistent. You'll see it's not perfect. That's because the top and the bottom of the valve spring are never perfect the way they're built. But what we're looking for is to make sure that it's not bowed like a banana. And this valve spring looks pretty good.